This is Laura GB, and in this Power BI video, we're going to have a look at creating a simple chart in the Charticulator Visual. So let's start by looking at what we're going to be building. Here is the chart we're going to build. Okay, it's a very simple bar chart with showing the drink preferences for 20 people, so 12 people like coffee, etc. So let's move across to build this chart. So here we are in Power BI. I've already loaded the data ahead of time. So let's just have a quick look at that data. We have a table of data here, three columns. We're looking at the first two today. We've got people and we've got drinks. And I've added one measure called people count, and that just counts the rows of how many in that table. Okay, so actually we're only looking at one column. We're looking at the drink column and how many rows there are per drink. So let's go back in to our visual pane. And if we look over here in the visualizations pane, we don't have the Charticulator visual. So if we click on the three dots and get more visuals, and then in this pane, there's a search in the top right hand corner. And if we type in chart I, there we are, there's a Charticulator visual. And when this comes up, we can press add. I recommend at some point doing the download sample. It's got lots of examples in it and it's good. Let's click add. It gives you a message about an update coming. And there we are, we've got the Charticulator visual over there on the right. So let's click on there. And then let's drag it down a little bit and make it a little bit bigger. So the first thing we need to do is we need to add some data to it. So I am going to bring in the drink. And I'm going to bring in people count. Be aware, if you just tick them, the chances are one of them will end up in links, and that's not where you want them. So make sure they're all in data. And then we can click on the three dots and we can go to edit. And we are going to create a chart. So here we are in the blank editor. The glyph is what is drawn for every row of data. And in the middle here, we have the chart and the plot area. So we want a rectangle for every row of data. So the way we do that is up here on the marks, we've got the shape of a rectangle. We pick that up, we click on it and drag and drop it into the glyph. And there we are, we get in the plot area, three rectangles. So we want the widths of those rectangles to be based off how many people like that drink. So if we look down at the attributes here, we can see there's a width box. So I am going to click on the link button and I'm going to link it to people count. And there we are, they all change width. But they're all the same colour at the moment. We also get a box that comes up about scale. We don't need to worry about that for a second. Let me click back onto the glyph at the top here, the shape. Okay, so we've now got in their average people count as the calculation for the width. If we scroll down, we can see that there is a colour. We wanted a different colour per drink. So let's click on the link button there again. And this time click on drink. And there we are, we get three colours. We can edit those colours by typing in colours into here, but I'm going to leave mine as they are. The next thing I want to do is I want to get rid of this white gap between my different segments. So that is in the plot segment. So if I click on plot segment in the layers box, and I scroll down, you'll see there is a gap that says 10% at the moment. So let's change that to say zero. And there we are, the gap has gone. So the next thing I want to do is I want to add some text to these boxes. So what we're going to do is up here, If you look, there is a text pot. Now, there's two kinds of text things. There's a text box and there's text. For this one, we just want text. So I'm going to grab that and I'm going to drop it into the glyph again. And there we are, we get some text in there. Okay, it currently just says text, so let's change that first. So in the text box here, there's a little link button. So I click on there and I'm going to pick drink. It's also in black and perhaps a little bit too small. Up to you, really. So I'm going to hit, we can up the size or we could type in a size. And if we keep scrolling down, we'll find there is a color. So I'm just going to change that color to be white. So I click on the color there and I can click in there. So there we are, it becomes white. Now, if we look over here in the glyph box, okay, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do a zoom in. You can see the text there, a little green dot above it, which is the very center of your glyph. Okay, and if we scroll down, let's go back, click on our text. Sorry, scroll up, my apologies. To anchor and rotation, we can see that there is a left and right and center. Okay, anchor X and anchor Y is up and down. So at the moment, it's stuck underneath the one, so I'm going to put it above. And you can even put in a bigger gap if you wanted. Okay, so there's a margin there. You can arrange that how you like. So that now puts that above the text. We're now going to put in another text item. So let's drag in that A back onto the glyph again. And you'll see this one goes under. So this one here, I can link that text to the people count. Let's do the same things. Let's up the size a little bit. This time we're going to and change the color to be white. Now it's got decimal places. And in our data, we know full well we're going to have whole people. We're not looking at averaging over time or anything like that. So we want to get rid of that decimal place. And the way you deal with that is in the text. We can see in here there is some notation to specify how it's formatted. Now, this is D3 formatting. Now, there's a blog post I've done to go with this video, and it has the links to go and find all the details. But that dot 1F is one fixed decimal place. So we are going to go for editing that. Now, I've got a number of things in there I could do. I could go for 0 decimal places, or I can put in a D. And when I click off that to somewhere else, we'll see that gives me no decimal places. Okay, so that D says round to an integer. So that works. So there we go, I've got that part. It's a bit tall, the chart, and I don't particularly want that. So going back to my layers, I can go to my charts and I can see that in the attributes we've got a width and we've got a height. Well, let's change that height to just be 200. And I've got quite a lot of white space around it, and that's due to the margins. Now, if you want to see more of the attributes without having to scroll up and down, you can minimize. So I can click on that arrow there to minimize the glyph. And then I can see parts in here. So let me just change these margins to demonstrate that you can do. So let's do left and let's do right. And there you are, we can see that the gap has got smaller. You can decide what's going to work for you. So now I've got my chart done and I'm happy. We can click up in the top left-hand corner, we can click back to report. And it asks us for a save button. And there we are. We've got a chart up there. We could change the title, etc. Be aware though, that text size is fixed. So as you resize, It will sort itself out, but that text will stay the same size. So you've got to think about that a little bit as to how that's going to work. So that was creating a simple chart using the Charticulator visual. If you haven't already, please press subscribe. Take care now.